All right, we got another weekly breakdown. We have the first week of September, and we are going to be going over all the usual pairs. So just wanted to let you guys know before we start this, I've had some crazy allergies recently, so my nose is stuffed up, so my voice might sound a little weird, and that is the reason why. So we're just going to get right into it, and we're going to start with US 30 this time. So US 30 on the daily is extending downwards, right? We're going into recession, and the market is, as you can see, if I highlight, the market is making its way down. We had one last huge pullback to 34K, and now we're right here. Now, let me redo all the, delete all these. So what we're looking for on US 30 is a sell continuation down into, ultimately, what I'm looking for is around 27,000 right in here. But that is some major swing trades and intraday trades along the way. So to get into what is going on now, going on this week, what I'm really looking for is, I'll show you better on the 4 hour actually. I want to see price push down into this area right here, right around 30,700. Let me mark this up. So see how price pushed up right here. And then we have this area right here of orders that was tapped into again right here. Okay, price squeezed and then it shot up again. What I'm looking at is this last little area right here. We can see how price pushed up and then it had a little pullback before it launched, right? And then it pulled back down here and we launched again. So what I'm looking for, because of how price pushed off of this area, and this to me in my eyes is like the last pullback, right? Obviously we have this one, but this is the last pullback where all the low, I don't know what just happened. Sorry, one sec. I accidentally hit the space bar. All of this accumulation down here, if we look under the key level here, so bring your eyes below the level and just look up. See all this accumulation right here? This is the last little bit of accumulation from this area before it taken off. So what that tells me, price is attracted to that area and there is a lot of orders on that area, on that level. And I would like to see price dump down into that level again. And it's possible from that level we actually see a larger pullback, because as you can see here, price has dumped 2,800 pips already in a pretty short amount of time. And yeah, I think we're going to see a little bit more of a continuation before possibly pulling back even all the way up to these highs right here at 32,300. So if the bias, if the analysis is short down to this level right here, where is the best place to enter? And going into the 2 hour, what I see is the supply from this area right here. So as you can see, this wick is when the sell started. It pushed up here, tapped this high perfectly, and which also retested this level, right? We tapped that absolutely perfectly and then it dumped. So what I would like to see is price pull back up to this area, not necessarily take out the high. Maybe it will, but I'm not really looking for that. What I'm looking for is price just pull back into this area in general, specifically this 2 hour level, as you can see I marked up here. I want to see price at least touch that, and from there that is where I am going to be looking to sell from. Now, it is possible price just pulls up above this wick high right here slightly and then continues down. And maybe we'll take a short up here if that's how it plays out. But overall, I would love to see a little bit of a bigger pullback. But again, we'll just have to wait and see what happens, because it is possible price just pulls up another 100 or 200 pips and taps these levels right here and then drains. So that is like a second scenario that's possible. So it all depends what happens when price hits this 31,500. If price just smashes right through it, then obviously we're going to be looking to short up here. But if it pulls up to it and it starts rejecting and it can't break it and it's slowing down, and on the low time frame it looks like some sellers are stepping in and the structure looks good for sell, then of course we'll just sell it right here at 31,500. Honestly, this might happen. I mean, just looking at the last week and the weeks prior, it is possible that price just pulls back slightly. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. I'm going to go like this. So short between these areas with the target down here, which is around 1,000 pips if it can pull up high enough. And we'll just be holding that. All right, it is probably going to be something like this, where it drops, pulls back a little bit, and then continues down. But we'll cross that bridge when it comes to it. For now, we'll just wait and see what type of reaction we get at 31,500. And moving on into crypto, we have Bitcoin. Bitcoin, I am still betting on the sells, right? So what I'm looking for is a third leg down. Okay, we have this first one, slight pullback. Second one, some consolidation. This one's a little bit more sideways, and looking for a third one. Right, normally the market pushes in threes. So like here, we have a one, two, three, and then it chopped around and then it pushed the other way. So now we have a one, two, hopefully get a three, probably chop around, and it's probably not gonna reverse. Maybe after it dumps to like 16,000, it pulls back up to 20, like where it is right now. I could see that happening for sure, but let's not get too far ahead. So we're already in sells. I've been shorting this past week. Pretty much every single time it hit 2,500, I entered a sell. Usually just set a limit up at 2,500 or 2,450, and then I just watch it hit it. And I'm still holding most of those. I did close one of them early today when price was down here, just because swap fees are nuts and because of my current analysis for this week. So what I'm expecting is price on the new daily candle to create some sort of wick to the upside. Of course, that's how we always kind of determine and break down the analysis. What I'm looking for specifically is this daily level that I marked up. This wick high is specifically why I have this level here. But if we drag that to the left, you can see it lines up with these daily levels as well. So back to the 4H. And if I wanted to drag this over on the 4H, you can see right here how it's pretty much playing on one side of this line or the other. So it's either chilling up here and rejecting the top or the other way around. So it's a pivotal point around 20,000. And what I like to see is price tap right above that 20,000 again and grab a little bit more liquidity. And then we see that downwards move. Similar to US 30 and really any pair, anytime we trade, you see this right here. This is where we were actually starting to sell, and then we had that huge spike up followed by the push down, and then we've had the weekend consolidation as normal. So what I'm looking for is, this is pretty much the same thing, but just a different perspective of it, is I want to see price pull into this 4-hour candle, and we can narrow that down by the 2-hour candle. We can see that was one huge candle. And what specifically interests me is the gap between the bottom of this 2-hour wick right here. You can see what I'm marking up. And then the top of this wick right here. Okay, so this gap. I hope you guys can see that. The gap between this wick low and this wick high is specifically something where I want to see price push into, which is right around 20,200. So going forward, from a simple perspective, what I would like to do is short one more time at 20,200, and from there just hold it The first target is going to be like 17K and probably close a little bit of the trade there. But I'm looking mainly to see this thing actually drop down into like 15, 14,000. So when price hits 17K, I'm not like super keen on closing the whole trade or even partials. I mean, if it can just blast right through it. In my opinion, as price is approaching this structure low, let me mark this up, right? As we're approaching this low again, in my opinion, if it's going to break it, then it is going to smash through it, right? And just smashing through it, that immediately brings price to like 16K, 15K. And from that point, like I was saying just a little bit ago, it's possible we see price pull back to 20,000 before it makes its inevitable move even lower to like 10 grand. So when price hits like 16K, for sure, probably going to be closing a lot of the trade, a lot of the position, because at that point in time is a pretty good chance that we're going to see a bigger pullback, at least bigger than what we've seen here. An example of that would be, where is it? Like right here, see how price had this low right here, it pulled back, and when it smashed through, it completely smashed through. But then as you can see, price actually pulled back all the way up back to this area where it broke from before consolidating a bit, right? And then it inevitably pushed down to 17K. So I think we might see something similar to that, right? Just a steep drop off over the next week or so. And from there, it is probably going to chop around a little bit, and we'll assess it when the time comes. But yeah, in other words, simple terms, just shorting again around this area right here. And that's it. That's it for Bitcoin. So with that, we're going to move on with gold. Now, US 30, Bitcoin, and gold are pretty similar, right? Because they're all against the dollar. So if the dollar index is exploding, then typically these three pairs that we're going over right now, typically they start to move down, and all, not exactly the same, but all in general, they're moving down. So gold, we had an incredible short last week, right on the high of this wick, right on the first daily candle of the week. We tagged in a short that was absolute sniper, and the target was 1700, and it got smoked. Beautiful trade, 450 pips, very satisfying. And what I'm thinking is we're going to see that continue into next week. I think we're going to roll over into well, let me go to the weekly time frame, actually. Now, I think we're going to roll over into these levels right here, right? I think we're going to clear below 1680, and I think we're going to get into these next lows, and maybe even low 1600s. That would be crazy, but it's definitely possible. It is definitely possible. So we'll see what happens with that. But this week, what I'm expecting is a push lower than the previous week. In my opinion, this week's move has not been completed yet. And what I mean by that is like the overall move of this market going downwards isn't done. I don't think this is the bottom. I think we're going to continue shorting into, like I was just showing you, like maybe even low 1600s. You know, that's very possible. We're in a similar situation to this week right here. Not specifically right here, but see these lows? And then we got a nice pullback, and then price dumped. But then look, this candle right here wicked low, and then it closed up here. And then the next week, small pullback, and then it drained. So the market's never going to repeat itself exactly, but I think we're in that similar sort of place where price is going to have a smaller pullback, and then it's going to continue down and break this low. And honestly, if it's going to break this low, it's probably going to break this low too. So that's why I have that daily level at 1660 marked up. And that is this week's target. So 1660 by Friday, price is going to hit it. So where do we short it then? All right, so what I'm looking for is this daily candle's high to be taken out. All right, I think this week, if it's going to drop another 600 pips, it's probably going to pull up a little bit and gather a little bit more orders. It's not just going to, you know, pull up 30 pips and then drop, right? I think we are going to break this high, and my eyes are on are 1720, right? This low right here, which is also, if we go in the 4 hour, we can see this whole area in general. That would bring the market to retest this whole area in general. And that is exactly where I want to enter my shorts, right around 1720, maybe mid 1720s. It depends what happens here. But overall, just I want to short up in this area and hold that short down to 1660 for a solid 600 pips. This is that last week short right here. Literally shorted right at the top of this wick. So the high of this wick is 1745.5, and that short entry was 1745.3. 2 pips away. It's beautiful. So we're looking to recreate that this week with another beautiful short 5 minutes. I'm just looking at something real quick. So this is what I'm looking at right here. This little stubble of 5 minutes. Right here specifically. Because that's where it broke. And then if we bring that back, that's 1718. Right? So 1718 is, that is higher than Friday's high. So it's possible that we start entering at like right at 1718 or 1719. Just in general, I just want to see this high taken out. I don't care if it's by 1 pip or 50 pips. I just want to see price come higher than this high, and then we'll assess, do we enter now or is it going to bump up a couple more pips? I mean, look at the structure. There's no way this isn't going a little bit higher. I would be genuinely surprised, though, if it starts to range right here between the high and this level right here. It's just got to come up higher than that high. It really does. So that's what we're looking for in gold, is a short. So before I move on to the pound pairs, because that's it for gold, I just want to show you how similar these are. Right, we're looking for a smaller pullback followed by like a 1,000 pip dump on US 30. Same with Bitcoin, you know, like a, that's only 30 pips, 25 pips pullback followed by, you know, 400 pip dump. And then same with gold, right? So they're, I just want to show you, they're all pretty similar. It's kind of, yeah, they're all kind of the same. And now I'm just looking. I'm seeing if there's something very similar to compare to. Where was that? It was right here, wasn't it? It was right here. So that daily example that I was showing you guys, or it was on the week, we had that low, and then the, you remember the day closed out with a huge wick, and then it tanked. So that's this right here. So this, let me mark it. This is Friday, this is Monday. And as you can see, Friday's high, it got stopped out by, well, not stopped out, but Friday's high, or where it closed at, the high where it closed at, price pushed almost 3 pips higher than it, and then it dropped. So again, not exactly the same. It doesn't have to be, but I want to see this high get stopped out a little bit or pushed up. I want to see price push up a little bit higher than it, and then we sell. Let me delete that line. All right, so that's it for all the pairs that are against the dollar. We're just going to take a look at the dollar real quick, and then we're going to get into all the other pairs, which is just some pound pairs. So I'm not going to break this down like in 4 hour and 1 hour. I only look at the dollar index in the daily. Honestly, I don't even really look at the dollar index, but just for to show you guys, I think we're going to make a third spike to the upside. And from there, let me show you why I have that marked actually. It's like a weekly neckline. It's really a little bit higher. It's like right here. You see how it was like a neckline? So that's really what I'm looking for is, you know, another push up. And from there, at some point, the dollar is going to come crashing down and we will catch some crazy longs on gold and Bitcoin, maybe Bitcoin. I have a theory that I'm pretty much making up on the spot, or I'm thinking up on the spot. I thought about it once a little bit, but I have a theory that Bitcoin is going to drop heavily. Like, it's going to absolutely tank to like 12,000 or 10,000 or something crazy. It's just going to freaking drop. And after it does that, we see the dollar index at the same time would be exploding. So then we see the dollar index flip and start crashing. And that would bring Bitcoin back up to like in the 20s, and it would fly gold up like into 1800s, and US 30, it might even correct US 30, right? If US 30 drops down, you know, a decent amount, then we could pull back like 2000 pips. So we'll see what happens. That's just something I just kind of thought about. All right, let's get into the pound pairs. I guess this is actually pretty similar to gold and all that because it's against the dollar, right? We got the British pound to the dollar. Overall, I would like to see this continue down. I think the British pound as itself, disregard the correlation between the dollar index and all that, I think just the pound in general is becoming a very weak currency at the moment, just with the state of the economy and everything going on over there. I think it is, yeah, it's not looking good for the pound. So I think that in itself is going to bring the pound to new lows. And then you mix that with the dollar going, or the dollar index going bullish, then it's just like strapping rocket boosters to that short. So last week, we were looking to short right here off this new daily candle. We were looking for a pullback a little bit higher, and it drained, and it just kept draining, and it didn't really pull back to a good spot where I personally wanted to enter off of. So last week, I personally, you know, analyzed the short, and it didn't come up to the entry, and I just watched it fall over like 200 pips. And this week, I think we're going to see something similar to that. What I'm looking for is a possible touch of yesterday or Friday's high. So one at 1.589. I would love to see price hit 1.589 and then continue down. Very similar to like right here. As you can see, we have like these daily highs right here. See how they kept getting touched and then it pushed down. And then it came back up, but then it pushed down again. But this happened after price already dropped 500 pips. Right? So we had this huge drop, 500 pips, and then it drops another 200 off that high, off those daily highs. And price right now is, it's dropped like 800 pips, hasn't it? Yeah, 800 pips. But overall, what I'm just looking for is price to come back to these daily highs, maybe even spike above it a little bit, about a couple pips. That would be cool too. And then I'm looking to short it into this low right here, which is this week low on the weekly time frame. Now, if I zoom all the way out, you can see we're getting into all-time low territories. Now, check this out, though, right? Because this drop looks pretty insane. I mean, and it is. That's 2,000 pips. But look, this was 2,000 pips in 2 weeks. You know, now we're at 3,000 pips. Look at this. 6,000 pips. 2,000. I mean, you get the idea. Like, if we look back here, you would think, again, we're on the weekly time frame. This is almost straight down. 2,000 pips straight down. Now, week by week, you can see it just keeps going lower and lower and lower. Where's 800 pips at? 800 pips is right here. So this little chunk right here, you would think, okay, we're touching these lows right here. We're going to have some sort of retracement higher before it pulls back. But nope, just keeps dropping. And I think that's very possible right now. Like I said, with the pound just being super weak in general, and mix that with the dollar index gaining strength, I think the pound can just continue to trend its way downwards. Now, this doesn't make sense because this is 11 day. I thought it was 1 day. I was like, dude, that does not look right. So yeah, basically simple terms, if price can pull back up here, that's where I want to short it from. I'm not really impatient with it. You know, I just want to see it come back up to this level and reject, because that's a good spot. That's a good stop loss placement, a good target. Honestly, now that I'm thinking of it, if we're going to break this low, like, if we're coming to this low, we're probably going to break it. Which, then we're getting into literally uncharted territory. So it's hard to predict where the low will be. I mean, dude, we could really, you know, let's see. We could really bring this pound back towards, like, where the euro's at. Like, £1 equals $1. That would be crazy. And it's so possible. It's very, very possible. We'll just have to see what happens. I'm just comparing this now. I haven't done this yet. Because, like, if we look at this, so yeah, that's 1,400 pips. This thing really sent it. I mean, goodness gracious. What a short right there, man. What a short. All right, so moving on. The pound, yen. So obviously, just speaking about the pound weakness makes me think this is going to go bearish. However, because this is a yen pair, the yen basket heavily influences this. So I've seen it many times where the British pound is dumping. And what I mean by that is the pound dollar market is dumping. Yet this is flying upwards. And again, the reason is because the yen. So my predictions is with the dollar gaining strength, which is going to bring down all the other pairs we've been talking about, that would also bring down the yen basket, theoretically. And I have been long bias on this for a while. And I switched to shorts sometimes, and I've caught some shorts, but I've mainly been buying. And that's because of this daily structure here, as well as the fundamental analysis with the yen becoming weaker, especially if China and Taiwan's gonna have a war. That could cause some mayhem in the markets, especially like the yen market, aka bring the yen down. So I'm leaning into buys again, right? So like for the past 2 weeks, if you look at this market, this chart, this has been horrible. I mean, it has just been super choppy. Every day is like spike up, spike down. It is just not beautiful at all. Normally it's beautiful. The structure is gorgeous. You can read it perfectly. Everything makes sense. But lately, I mean, it has been just crazy. Like, it's overall been kind of clean, but it's also been super choppy at the same time. So what I'm looking for, excuse me, what I'm looking for again, I'm tapping in with the buys. I'm gonna try the buys again. I really do think it's gonna go up. I think this pattern has just been nuts and it's just chopped everyone out. It's liquidated out sellers, it's liquidated out buyers, it's liquidated out the people sitting on their hands. They don't even know what's going on, right? Now, what I'm seeing is, again, taking my eyes on the bottom of the screen and looking upwards, what am I seeing? I'm seeing these spikes. I'm seeing these taps in, these taps. And I also see this right here being broken, tapping in that sell liquidity, coming back down. And here's the thing, it could have kept going right here. Like if it was gonna short, hold on, let me draw this out. If it was gonna short, this would have been the perfect opportunity to bring it, to sink it down to like 158, like down here. Because you got in all these buyers and you got all these buyers hyping up right here. And then you got a ton of sellers come in right here. And then you come back up and you get more sellers in there. And then you drop a little bit and then you tap in even more sellers. So there were so many opportunities for the banks to fulfill enough sells to drop this market down like crazy. Yet what happens? Price taps this area and immediately it says, forget all of these sells. Those don't mean anything to me. We're going up again. And that leads me to the question of why. You know, why is it not breaking that? Like, why is it it's been here for 2 weeks? Like, why it's had so many opportunities to fulfill sell orders and break that low. Why has it not breaking that low yet? It just makes no sense. Unless they're just trying to chop everyone up and get the buys. So what I'm going to be looking for is buys pretty immediately. This candle opened, obviously the market just opened 47 minutes ago. This candle opened just now and the spread has pushed it down here. I'm looking to see if price holds this again because now we're tapping into it again. So if price holds this, then I'm buying it and the target is going to be these highs up here. Now, it could finally, if it's going to short, it's gonna break this. Like it's got to. It's been trying for weeks, literally weeks, it's been trying to break this low, and it's now at the point where, look, it tapped into these cells again. You can see right here it tapped in. If it's gonna break it's gonna do it now. Not like literally right now, but like tonight or the next day, it's gonna break it if it's gonna short. But if that doesn't happen, that just moves all the chips into buys because why would it not buy at that point? It's happened in here so many times. So for GJ, I'm just waiting to see what happens. Staying a little bit more patient with this one and overall looking to buy it. Now the last market we're going to be looking at today is the pound Aussie, which we've gotten some awesome trades from. We had some shorts right here Then it started chopping around a little bit, and I was pushing back down again. To me, it really could go two ways. I'm leaning towards the short. I think this market in general is just pushing down. And I had a vision. Okay, I had a vision a while ago when the price was right here and I saw it hitting 168. And as you can see, Friday's low was 1.688. I really think this market's going to continue to move down. So what I'm looking for is a short opportunity. I would like to see price come back up into this area right here. Right above this daily levels. I think if we can wick right above here and we reject, that's going to be an amazing short. And it's probably going to, probably going to drop, 300 pips. Specifically, what I'm looking for is this 4-hour wick right here. That's why this was up to that level. It was the wick high. I want to see this 4-hour wick. I want to see price come back into this area because this is the last spot that price pushed away from on this move down. And I think if we're going to make a full move down 300 pips, it's going to pull itself back up to this price point and fulfill those orders right there. And then we're going to see it actually tip over another 300 pips to this low. And I'm just going to leave it at that. There's not that much in-depth breakdown here with this pair. Just simply looking to see that 4-hour liquidity area tapped. Enter the short and watch it drop. Does anyone have questions? It's just the homies out here.